man. Y'all know the tennis preacher, the prophet, the psychic. Coming back at you again with another video. Okay, people, let me slow down and get down with this thing. People, this topic is probably, it's the most, it may be the most, I don't know, most important topic, but it's definitely the most, I would say it may be the most important topic, maybe the most complicated topic, maybe the most interesting topic that I've ever talked about since I started my channel last July. Now, people, if somebody was going to call me to speak about tennis, and they said, Magic Man, you got over 800 videos you have done, and we want you to come and speak about any tennis topic, but it must be one topic from one of your videos. What would be the topic that I would choose? People, it would be this particular topic that I'm getting ready to talk about. And people, I know I've talked about a lot of greatness things, but I've never talked about this. Never. Okay? And people, I have been thinking about it. And let me tell you why I've been thinking about it. People, I've heard a lot of fans, and I'm not talking about crazy fans. I'm saying really intelligent fans, sound-minded fans. I've heard experts say this. I've heard Nadal fans say this. I've heard Federer fans say this. I heard the Djokovic fans say this. I've heard this from whoever tennis fans. They'll say this. See, listen, people. See, this thing is so complicated, I don't even know how to ask the appropriate question. So, I guess this is, I'm going to try to ask two questions to put this on topic. Here it is, people. I've heard this right here. One commenter said this the other day. He said, I don't believe in the GOAT. I really don't believe there is really a GOAT, okay? Now, listen, people, let me just say something about that. Now, some people can say that out of just, some people can't really mean that. I think that commenter meant it. Now, was he saying it because he just is intelligently thinking that I can't decide who's the GOAT between Federer or Rod Laver? I mean, some people intelligently have made that conclusion. Even I told y'all, I don't know who's the GOAT between Rod Laver and Federer. And up to this day, it's not clear to me. I don't have a problem putting Federer number one. I wouldn't have a problem if somebody put Rod Laver number one. But it's not clear to me, that's what I'm saying, that Federer is not clearly the GOAT over Rod Laver. Okay, now some people do use it as like hate. It's like a hate excuse, meaning, so they don't want to make Federer the GOAT. So they'll say, well, I don't really think it's a GOAT. So that they can't say Federer is the GOAT. Okay, some people do that. But people, I think most people that I've heard that say, is there really a GOAT? Now, people, listen. I don't know if that's the question I want to use as the theme. I think that's one of the questions. Is there really a GOAT? Okay, but people, I think this is the real question. Can you definitively say that a person's the GOAT? I think that's coming from me. Now, let me go back to the first question I asked. I said, is there a GOAT? Now, let me tell you what I think about that. I do believe that you can narrow down. I do believe that you can definitely narrow down who's in the GOAT discussion. Now, I don't want to hear this here. Now, some people, they try to make their favorite player the GOAT. I do not want to hear, if you're trying to tell, if Del Potro is your favorite player or Chilich, and you say, well, Chilich is my GOAT. Oh, no, that's your favorite player. And that's cool, but don't be calling Chilich the GOAT. Federer, Nadal, and all those guys, and even lesser players, is clearly the GOAT over Del Potro, who only got one major, okay? So, I'm not talking about, I know this is a subjective thing. I think there's intelligent subjectivity, and I think there is unintelligent subjectivity. To say that Del Potro is the GOAT because that's the way I see things, that's not intelligent, because there's thousands of players that have definitely surpassed Del Potro. Okay, so like I said, we ain't talking about making somebody the GOAT who's not even close. I'm talking about for all those great players that are worthy of the discussion. But people, even that's a debate. See how complicated it is. If we, who's to say who's in the discussion? I mean, there are some people that may say, there are some people that don't think Beyond Boar is in the discussion for the GOAT. And there are some people that think Beyond Borg, who has 11 majors, but he has a lot of other like records that other people don't have. I mean, little records like Most Sets, Juan doing a major and all kind of stuff like that. Somebody may say that puts him in the discussion. So this thing gets complicated then. Now, I do believe you need to have a certain amount of greatness achievements to be in the discussion. So this is the first thing. So the first thing I guess I'm trying to say is that if you, for all those that's in the discussion for the GOAT, and like I said before, that's a debate right there about who's really in the discussion. Are there people in the discussion that shouldn't be in the discussion? Or are there people not in the discussion that should be in the discussion? For example, let me just give you an example right here, people. Okay, let's say Jimmy Connors. Jimmy Connors only have 8 majors, okay? So somebody would say, well, Jimmy Connors, well, Beyond Boy got 11, so if people ain't going to put him in the discussion for the GOAT, I'm not saying that Beyond Boy is not in the discussion, but somebody may say, well, Jimmy Connors only got 8. How in the world can we put Jimmy Connors in the discussion? This is a good example. Y'all know I use the Djokovic for an example about how close he is to the GOAT. People, Jimmy Connors, listen, people. Well, let me finish this thing. So somebody would say, Jimmy Connors is totally not in the discussion for the GOAT. He only got 8 majors. Pete Sampras got 14. Rod Laver got 11 or whatever. We know Rod Laver could have 20 and some. Everybody know the story with Rod Laver. But Federer got, Nadal got 16. Federer got 20, blah, blah, blah. Players in between got more than 8 majors. Okay. But then, here we go where it gets complicated. Jimmy Connors got a longevity that probably only Federer and maybe Rod Laver can counter. Barely, okay? And Jimmy Connors got the most titles of all time in the Open era, 109, and Federer only got 96, I believe. And Federer, it's possible Federer may not break that record. So the Jimmy Connors fans could say, well, Federer got 20 majors, but Jimmy Connors, his total number of singles titles, which includes majors too, he got 109, and that's more than Federer got. And so we think Jimmy Connors, if not the GOAT, he's definitely in the conversation. So, and Jimmy Connors also got the longevity of Federer. Not quite at the high level Federer has presented the last couple years. But somebody could say, can you definitively say that Federer is greater than Jimmy Connors? Okay, somebody can see. And now this leads to something else. It leads to, see people, I'm telling you, this is complicated. Listen, people, I'm not going to get into some argument with Federer fans, Nadal fans. That's not, please, y'all, we're not going there. That's not what I'm trying. I'm not trying to say Federer is not the GOAT. I'm just showing y'all how this thing can be complicated based on how you, and this is the next argument I'm going to, is how you frame the narrative for who's the GOAT. For example, I think it was Paul Mussington. He's one of these subscribers. He made a great suggestion, and I forgot to do a video. I was going to do a video on it, and it had to do, I mentioned, I took and did a video on like the Jimmy Connors greatness, and it was sort, I did sort of dip into how do we rank achievements. And for example, somebody may say, well, 20 majors that Federer got, okay, majors should be number one. Okay, but then somebody could say it should be the total number of singles titles. That should, in other words, the total, because your total number of singles titles include the majors. So somebody could say, well, it should be the total number of singles titles. And so you say, so you'll put 109 by Jimmy Connors' name, okay? You'll put 96 by Federer, and then you have to break it down and say, okay, a major is worth, you have to do something like this here. You can say a major is worth 2 points. Then you can say something like, a master series is worth, well, you could say the ATP finale is worth 1.5. A master series tournament is worth, you said master series tournament is worth maybe 1.0. Then you could go like 500 if worth 0.5. And then you could say a 250 tournament is worth 0.2, I guess 0.25. You could do that. Then you can start. Then that at least tell you. You can put. Then you, that'll tell you who's the greatest as far as total singles titles. But then you got to do all the other achievements. Who was number one for the most weeks? Who won the most ATP finales? Who beat the most top 10 players? Who had the longest longevity? Who won the most majors after 30? You can do all that kind of stuff there. But people, y'all see how that is? It's really complicated. Okay, this whole, like I said, you can rewrite the narrative. Somebody could rewrite the narrative for Djokovic. They can say, well, Federer didn't beat, he didn't dominate his rivals, okay? But the Djokovic, not only did he dominate Nadal, he dominated two rivals and created his era. But I know Federer had his era, but the Djokovic didn't let his rivals beat him. Somebody can rewrite the narrative and say, that's a big measurement for the GOAT, okay? So, y'all understand what I'm saying? This whole GOAT debate can get really complicated. It depends on how you rewrite the narrative, or what your narrative is. What is your requirement for being the GOAT? Then people, there are the intangibles. Like, who got the best game? See, people, let me tell y'all something about, I'm gonna tell y'all something about Pete Sampras is one of my favorite players. Pete Sampras got one of the highest IQs of all time, okay? Even Federer, up to about a couple years ago, I always thought Pete Sampras' IQ was even higher than Federer's. I think now Federer is almost tied with him as far as IQ on the court. And also, Pete Sampras, people, he was the first one to get to 14 majors, okay? So somebody, let's say somebody could say, well, my definition of a GOAT is the guy with the high IQ, highest tennis IQ. And somebody could say, well, we think that if a guy is a pioneer of something, he's the greater player. For example, if what's greater, the iPhone 1 or the iPhone 10? Of course, the iPhone 10 is more efficient, but who's to say the iPhone 10 is greater than the iPhone 1? You understand? So somebody could say, and in some cultures, in some countries, they think, in some societies, they think the pioneer of something, the grandmother, is greater than the grandchild. In other words, Federer is the pioneer of, Pete Sampras is the pioneer of Federer. So somebody could rewrite the narrative and say, hey, we don't care if Federer got 20. Sampras was the first one to get there, and that's greater. Federer, he just followed after Sampras. Somebody could rewrite a narrative like that. So y'all see how this whole GOAT thing can get really complicated. Okay, people? Now, let me close on this here. Now, people, let me just say this here before I close on the last narrative and argument about this whole, can you definitively say who's the GOAT? I don't know if I answered the question before. Do I believe you can definitively say who's the GOAT? I believe you can definitively say who's the GOAT if there is a great enough distance. Like, I think right now, as of right now, I think Federer is the GOAT. I think I can definitively say, but barely, that Federer is the GOAT over Nadal. Just barely now. I can't definitively say Federer is the GOAT over Rod Laver. Okay, now listen, if Nadal gets 19 and 20, then it's going to be hard to say Federer is definitively the GOAT over Nadal. I probably won't be able to say that then. Okay? But now, let me say something here. People, I thought of something today. See, I think the word GOAT is what messes people's mind up. I don't think, see, this is what I think. I think there should be different GOATs, and they should rank the GOATs. See, I think if they did that, there wouldn't be such a controversy with this. In other words, let's suppose they had, like, Federer's GOAT 1, okay? Or you could have, like, dual GOATs. You could say Federer and Rod Laver are dual GOATs. You could say number 2, You could have, I'm just going to say something, Nadal or Ken Rosewall, one of those is two or three, GOAT two or GOAT three. See, people, if they did it that way, see, I think the problem people got, like, if they got a problem with this one GOAT. That one guy is the GOAT, the greatest, and I know they still say Nadal is one of the top greatest of all time. But I think what Nadal fans got a problem with is that it's almost like there's this Federer's the GOAT, and Nadal ain't got no part in this GOAT. See, no. See, I believe Nadal is like 85% a GOAT. And if you that much of a GOAT, I think you should be like a GOAT 2 or 3 or whatever it is. So I think they should have like, there should be like 10 GOATs that's ranked. So that's GOAT 1, there's GOAT 2, there's GOAT 3, there's GOAT 4. See, if they put it that way, then people won't feel that there is this one guy that's the GOAT and everybody else is something else. Because see, people, there is stuff that, there's things that Bjorn Borg got that Federer doesn't have. Like, I think Bjorn Borg is more, I think he got a higher mental focus. They got great mental focuses, but they don't count that. That's, I think Bjorn Borg's mental focus is greater than Federer's mental focus. And of course, there's thousands of things Federer got that Bjorn Borg doesn't have. But so I'm saying, so if Bjorn Borg is GOAT number 6, at least we recognize him as a GOAT. Now, he may be a lesser GOAT than Federer, but still he's a GOAT. Now, somebody, like I said before, may say, well, Magic Man, what's the difference between calling somebody a GOAT, GOAT 6, and just calling him one of the greatest of all time? No, it's the difference is that it won't make fans and stuff. With me, it won't make a big of a difference. But there are people that think that, okay, if Federer's the GOAT, then Rod Laver's just some great player floating around somewhere. But if you call Rod Laver GOAT 2, you at least saying Rod Laver is 98% of Federer's GOATness. Rod Laver's GOATness is 98% of Federer's GOATness. So, people, listen, that's it for part one of this series. I don't know if I'm going to do another series today. I may do the next one tomorrow, maybe next week, but until I finish this GOAT thing, I'm not finished. I'm going to keep doing it, and I'm going to take my time and do it. If somebody makes some comments that I think is worth responding to make a topic about the can you definitively call somebody the GOAT? Can you definitively say that? Or is there really a GOAT? So I would continue this series on that. Okay, people? Tennis Preacher, Prophet Psychic, sign out.